In this video, we're continuing on with our KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 2 free worksheet, Systems of Inequalities, picking up on the second page with number 5. Now remember our steps. First, we're going to graph the inequality and then decide which side to shade to, and then the shaded region that overlaps is our solution. So for number 5, our first inequality is x is less than or equal to negative 3. If we were to graph this as an equation, x would be equal to negative 3, which means that regardless of the y value, x is always negative 3, which means this is going to be a vertical line. So if y was 0, x would be negative 3. If y was 3, x would be negative 3. If y was negative 2, x would be negative 3, and so on. And because this is less than or equal to, we're going to connect those points with a solid line. Now we're going to decide which side of this solid line to shade to. Let's use our test point of 0, 0. If we were to plug 0 in for x, we would get that 0 is less than or equal to negative 3, which is not true. And because that's not true, we're going to shade in the region that's opposite that test point. So we're not going to shade to the right where it includes the test point, we're going to shade to the left of this line. Now let's look at our next inequality. We have 5x plus 3y is greater than or equal to negative 9. Now there's two ways we can go about doing this. First, we can plug in a value for x, solve for y, graph that point, then plug in a new value for x, solve for y, and graph that point. However, the method I like to do is to put this in slope-intercept form and use our y-intercept and our slope to graph our points. So the first step we're going to need to do in order to get this in slope-intercept form is subtract 5x from both sides. In doing this, we'll get 3y is greater than or equal to negative 5x minus 9. Now, my next step will be to divide both sides by 3 to get that y all by itself. So y will be greater than or equal to negative 5 over 3, so negative 5 thirds x minus 9 over 3, which 9 over 3, or 9 divided by 3, is 3. So now you can see from our inequality, which these are equivalent, I just wrote it in a different form, our slope m is negative 5 over 3, or we can write this as positive 5 over negative 3, and our y-intercept b is a negative 3. So I'll start by graphing our y-intercept of 0, negative 3, and then I'm going to use positive 5 over negative 3, because if I was to use negative 5 over positive 3, I would be off our coordinate system when graphing my next point. So if I go up 5 and then 3 to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, I'll be at the point negative 3, positive 2. So that's the next point on my line. And because this is greater than or equal to, I will be using a solid line to connect those points. Now again, I'm going to be using my test point of 0, 0 to decide whether I'm going to shade to the right of that line or to the left of that line. So using my test point, I can either plug 0 in for x and y in that original unmodified inequality, or I can plug it into my new inequality that I formed from the old one. Let's use that new one. So I'll plug 0 in for y, so I'll get 0 is greater than or equal, and then I'll plug 0 in for x, so that's negative 5 thirds times 0 minus 3. So that 0 is greater than or equal to 0 minus 3, which gives me that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3, which is indeed true. So I'm going to be shading to the side that contains my test point of 0, 0, and that's going to be to the right. And from there, you can see where my shaded regions intersect, which is this small upper portion. So that's my solution in number 5. That means that I can pick any point within that shaded region, and that would be a solution to both inequalities, and therefore a solution to the entire system. Now, continuing on to number 6, again, I'm going to rewrite each of these in slope-intercept form. So I have 4x minus 3y is less than 9. So I'm going to start by subtracting 4x from both sides. So I'll get that negative 3y is less than negative 4x plus a positive 9. Now, in order to isolate this y, I need to divide both sides by negative 3. However, remember, since I'm dividing by a negative, I need to switch or flip that inequality sign. So as opposed to being less than, it's now going to be greater than. So I'll get that y is greater than negative 4 over negative 3 will be a positive 4/3, and that's multiplied to x. And then I'll be adding that to 9 over negative 3, which will give me a negative number, so I'll be subtracting a positive 3. Because 9 divided by negative 3 is negative 3, and adding a negative is the same as subtracting a positive. So I'll get y is greater than 4/3 x minus 3. So from this, I'll get that my slope m is 4 over 3, and my y-intercept b is negative 3. So graphing this, 0, negative 3, as one point on the line, and then I'll go up 4 in the positive y direction, and over 3 in the positive x direction, to the point 3, 1, which I'll plot, and those two points will help me form my new line. However, it's less than, or greater than, therefore it's not going to be solid, but it will be dashed. Now I'll use my test point of 0, 0 to decide which side of the line to shade to. If I plug in 0 for y, I'll get that 0 is greater than 4/3, and then plug in 0 in for x, that's 4/3 times 0 minus 3, which gives me that 0 is greater than negative 3, which I know to be true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading above or to the left of this line because I'm shading the region that contains that test point. Next, I'll graph the second inequality. So I have x plus 3y is greater than 6. So I'll subtract x from both sides to help isolate that y term. So I'll have 3y on one side of my inequality, and that's going to be greater than negative x plus 6. Now I'll divide by a positive 3 to get that y is greater than negative 1/3 times x plus 6 divided by 3, which is 2. So my slope m is negative 1/3, or negative 1 over 3, and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So graphing 0, 2, and then using my slope to find that next point, I'll go down 1 in the y direction and 3 to the right in the x direction to the point 3, 1. Now because this is greater than, I'm going to connect those with a dashed line. Now I need to decide which side to shade to. Using my test point of 0, 0, am I going to shade below or am I going to shade above? Plugging in 0 for y and 0 for x, I'll get negative 1/3 times 0 plus 2 on my right side of my inequality and 0 on my left side. So I have that 0 is greater than 2, which is not true. Therefore, I'm going to shade not below the line, but above the line where it does not contain my test point of 0, 0. And there you can see my overlap. So that is my solution in number 6. Now let's continue on to number 7. In number 7, I'll start by rewriting this first inequality. So I have x plus y is greater than 2. So subtracting x from both sides, I'll get that y is greater than negative x plus 2. So my slope m is negative 1, or negative 1 over 1, and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So graphing 0, 2, that's my first point on the line, and then using my slope, I'll go down 1 and 1 to the right to get to the next point on my line. Now because this is greater than, I'm going to have a dashed line, not a solid line. Now I'll use my test point of 0, 0 to decide if I'm going to shade below to the left or above to the right. So plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, I'll get that 0 is greater than 0 plus 2. Or I can plug it back into my original inequality. Plugging 0 in for x and y, I'll get 0 plus 0 is greater than 2, which 0 is not greater than 2, therefore I'm shading to the opposite side of where that test point is. So that's going to be above the line. Next, I'll graph my second inequality. So that's 2x minus y is greater than 1. So I'll subtract 2x from both sides to get that negative y is greater than negative 2x plus 1. However, my y cannot be negative, so I'll multiply both sides by a negative 1. And when I multiply both sides by a negative 1, since I'm multiplying or dividing by a negative, I have to remember to flip that inequality sign. So I'll get that positive y is not greater than, but it's less than, positive 2x minus 1. And that's me distributing my negative 1 to the negative 2x and to the positive 1. So from this, my slope m is positive 2, which I can write as 2 over 1, and my y-intercept b is a negative 1. So 0, negative 1, and then using the slope to find that next point, I'll go up 2 and 1 to the right to the point 1, 1. Now I'll connect those with a dashed line because it's greater than or it's less than. Not greater than or equal to and not less than or equal to. So dashed line it is. And now I need to decide which side to shade to. Using my test point of 0, 0, I'll plug 0 in for x and y in that original inequality just to show you that you can use either. So I'll get 2 times 0 minus 0 is greater than 1. 2 times 0 is 0, so 0 minus 0 is greater than 1, which 0 is greater than 1 is not true. Therefore, I'm shading to the side that does not contain that test point, so as opposed to shading to the left, I'm going to be shading to the right. And you can see that that overlap occurs here. And that's my solution in number 7. Let's continue on to number 8. Now, number 8 will be the last problem that I go over in this video. However, if you haven't done so already, remember to click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video if you know somebody else that will also find it useful. So in number 8, we have x plus y is greater than or equal to 2 as our first inequality. In order to get this in the form of y equals mx plus b, I'll subtract x from both sides to get that y is greater than or equal to negative x plus 2, which for this, our slope m is negative 1, which I can write as negative 1 over positive 1, and our y-intercept b is a positive 2. So graphing 0, 2, and then from there, using my slope to find that next point, going down 1 in the rise and over 1 in the x, I'll get to the point 1, 1. Now, because this is greater than or equal to, I will be using a solid line to connect those points. Now, using a test point of 0, 0, I'll see if we're going to shade below or above that line. Plugging 0 in for x and y in either the original inequality or our modified one, let's use the one that's in the form of y equals mx plus b, I'll have 0 is greater than or equal to 0 plus 2, which 0 is greater than or equal to 2 is not true. Therefore, I'm not shading the region that contains that test point, so I'll shade that opposite region, which is above that line. Next, let's work on our next inequality. 4x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 1. So what I'll do is I'll subtract 4x from both sides. That'll give me that y is greater than or equal to negative 4x minus 1. So my slope m is negative 4, which I can write as negative 4 over 1, or I can write it as positive 4 over negative 1. And my y-intercept b is a negative 1. So plotting 0, negative 1, I'll go down 4, and then 1 to the right to get to my next point, or I'll go 4 up and to the left 1 to get to my other point. So you can utilize that slope either way. However, all you need is 2 points to form a line. And this line is going to be solid because it's greater than or equal to. So connecting those 3 points that I now have plotted, I'll then use my test point of 0, 0 to decide which side to shade to. So I'm either going to be shading to the right where that test point is contained, or I'll be shading to the left where that test point is not. So plugging 0 in for x and y, I'll get that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 4 times 0 minus 1, which will give me that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 1, which is indeed true. Therefore, I'm shading to the side that contains that test point, which is to the right of that line. And from there, you can see where my overlap is, which will give me my solution. And that's my solution in number 8. And again, one more time, that means if that's my solution, that I can pick any point within this shaded region, or because it's solid lines, on those solid lines that are intersecting that shaded region, those x and y values or those coordinates will hold true for both of my inequalities. That will be the solution to the system. Continue on to the next video, where I'll complete the third page, finishing problems 9 through 14. However, before moving on, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.